So when an object slides along a surface, we're all familiar with the fact that it doesn't just keep sliding in general. There's a force that resists the motion. So generally, when we give something a push along some sort of surface, it will eventually come to a stop. There's a force that is opposite the velocity and therefore causes an acceleration opposite the velocity. It depends on the nature of the surfaces. Smoother surfaces have less friction. Also, there's something about the sort of, I guess you could almost call like the properties of the material on the surface, the sort of chemical makeup and the tendency of certain chemicals to sort of have a sort of attraction to other molecules. But anyway, it also depends on this nature of the surface, and it depends on how hard the surfaces are pushed together. The harder you push two things together, the harder it is to slide one relative to the other. This force is always parallel to the surface. So if something is moving along a surface, it pushes in this back on it, parallel to the surface, and it is opposite to the motion. And by motion, we are always referring to velocity. So this force, which we use a lower letter F to represent, and we use this subscript K for kinetic. We're going to talk about kinetic friction first, and that is the friction that happens when an object slides. So kinetic means movement. So when an object is sliding across the surface, it has this kinetic friction. And kinetic friction is measured in newtons, like any other force. Damn, I keep breaking my pencils. I got them so nice and sharp, and now I'm ruining it. Anyway. So, what does this force depend on? It depends on the normal force, which is also in newtons. And that normal force is multiplied by this number, which depends on the nature of the surfaces. And that number is represented with the Greek letter mu, italicized, mu k we call it, which is known as the coefficient of kinetic friction. Now, if I take something in newtons and I multiply it by something and I want to get an answer in newtons, that something can't have any units because, hey, if I multiply newtons times newtons, I'd have newtons squared. So this has no units. And in fact, it is a pure ratio. If you rearrange this and put the n on the other side, mu k is the ratio of how much is friction compared to the normal force. And that's really a good way to think about it, is that the friction will always be some fraction, generally less than one. There are actually circumstances where it can be more than one, but in general, the friction will be like 1/10 or 1/100 or 2/3 of the amount of normal force pushing the two surfaces together. Now, even when an object is not sliding, there is still friction, and we're quite familiar with that. If you try to slide a heavy box across the floor, then you might not be able to move it at all. And the reason why you can't move it at all, you know, is because of friction. So there's still friction here, but there's no sliding going along. So when the object is not sliding, friction may be involved in stopping the sliding. This friction will increase to balance your force. So if you're pushing a box with a force of 1 newtons, then static friction can push back with 1 newton. So you push a little harder, 2 newtons. Friction pushes back with 2 newtons. You go harder, 3 newtons. Pushes back with 3 newtons. Then you push 4 newtons, and it can't push back that far. You sort of win, and so it starts to accelerate. So friction will increase to balance the other forces to stop the motion up to a maximum, after which the object will start to slide. So the less than or equal to sign below tells us that the formula only gives the maximum possible value of friction. And static friction could be less than this. So it's a very similar formula. We have mu s times n. Fs is now static friction, which is measured in newtons. Mu s is the coefficient of static friction. And it has no units. It is simply a ratio. And n is the normal force, which is measured in newtons. And it's going to take a little while to get used to the static friction, and especially that less than or equal to sign, because we're going to do a lot of questions where we are going to push the static friction to the limit, but we're not always going to push it to the limit. So you might get in the habit of always saying this is how much static friction is, but it isn't necessarily that. That's just the maximum it can be. It might be less if we're not pushing it to the maximum. So we have these two types of friction, and let's just clarify the difference between the two. Friction always exists along the surface of the two objects. That's what it is. It's a contact force where two surfaces are pushed together, and so there is a force between them which is parallel to that surface. So if you want to know whether friction or static or kinetic, think about those surfaces. Imagine those surfaces and see, is there any movement along those surfaces? If one of those is moving in a direction parallel to the surface, then of the other, then it is kinetic friction. If the two are not moving relative to each other, even just for the short time they are in contact, it is static friction. An example of this is a wheel rolling across the floor. So I'm going to try to use an example of this right here, and it's probably not going to work very well because we have this tiny little video, but we're going to imagine this is the floor and this is my wheel. My wheel is moving along the floor. Whoa. And what happens normally when a wheel moves along the floor is that, well, I should do it up here so you can see the bottom of the wheel better, is that anywhere where the wheel touches the ground, it's not sliding along the ground. It just touches for an instant and then moves along again. So the surface touches the ground. Its surface does not move relative to the ground or parallel to the ground. So the friction is static friction. So let me see if I have a bigger circle that I can use that with. Gosh, I should prepare for these things. Anyway, here is this piece of tape, and you can see there's a bump on that piece of tape. So this bump is like a wheel. I roll along, I roll along, I roll along. You see that bump? See what happens to that bump? That bump, it goes down, it doesn't slide across the ground. It goes down, it touches the ground, and now that bump comes back up again. So that bump was not sliding across the ground. That bump was just touching the ground and coming up again. So that is static friction. Now, we have these two coefficients of friction, and there is a connection between the two. They are related to each other, sort of. They're similar, but they're not identical. And in general, mu s is greater than mu k. So basically, it is very common that when something is sitting still, it's able to kind of grab the surface better. And then once you get it moving, it doesn't grab the surface as well. And so that friction between the object and the surface can be less. Although it sometimes is only a tiny bit less. There are some ideal circumstances where it isn't actually less. But in most cases, static friction is at least a little bit less than kinetic friction. And in some cases, it's much less.